Good morning, everybody, or afternoon, depending when you're having class. I'd like to introduce you to what I expect you to accomplish today. You'll notice the background around the picture here around me is Canvas for today. And so you are in Canvas, you are in the week of November 1st, and you are also on Thursday. So here's a couple of things you're gonna do. One thing is you have already picked up this piece of paper that has a packet of stuff about transportation. Now, we've talked about in the last five class days, America growing in size and power during the early 1800s. We spent some time with the growing in size with purchasing Louisiana. Most of you have made your paper slide video already about Lewis and Clark and some of their adventures. I've been very entertained with those. On Monday, we did the Barbary Pirate story, where the American Marines left the country for the first time to deal with a foreign problem. We also did the War of 1812 on Tuesday and a little bit of Wednesday. And so I guess the American military has now beaten the British twice, beaten the best army in the world two times, which is very exciting, growing in power. We've also spent some time at the Monroe Doctrine on Wednesday, where America's kind of being like a little kid who's trying to be a little tougher than they really are, saying, you European countries, you stay out of our business, our part of the world. And European countries, well, it kind of looks like it works because they don't really pay attention to us for most of the 1800s. We think we've scared them away with our Monroe Doctrine. Well, maybe they're just not interested in having colonies anymore. Colonies have kind of gone out of style. Well, today and tomorrow and part of next week, we're going to shift our focus for America growing in wealth and growing in some culture activities and culture items. You know, this class is called American Cultures. But we really don't have any American culture yet. We've been, all of our culture as far as art and literature and things like that is just copying what Europe has already done. Well, we're going to do that sort of story in a few days next week. Today, we're going to start working on big changes in the transportation business, the way we move from place to place, or the way we move stuff from one place to another. It's going to change a lot in the early 1800s. And that's what the packet of papers is about. You'll notice the first page says new roads of the early 1800s. When you look at the second page, there's a thing that says rates of toll on the national road, kind of like our first turnpike where you would pay to use the road. There is a page that's a map, and the map is of the early 1800s. You're going to be placing some roads on here, maybe kind of outlining where those roads go. And these are first roads built by the government for people to use. There is a fourth page, which is, well, I was just thinking a little bit about what are some of the vehicles that are new in the early 1800s. They are on the left side of your page. Let's see if you can match them up with vehicles that we have today on the right side of your page. They're kind of like a matching thing where you would draw a line from one vehicle and how it matches another. Like, here's an easy one for you. See the person walking. Walking is a form of transportation that matches with the person who is walking. If I can get that all in the picture at one time. There you go. And you would draw a line from one of those to the other. More about that here in a second. So let me show you on Canvas here what I expect you to do today. First thing is, first side of this page where it says new roads and highways. Well, that's where you're going to watch this video I've made that explains how we're starting to build roads differently to handle heavier equipment, heavier vehicles, and to get people to travel more. Activity number two, as with the map on this page, this map has a bunch of towns and things already on it. There's some dots. When you open the directions for this map, you're going to see what you need to do to complete the map. I'm opening it here, and you'll see that there's in bright red up here, do these steps in order. So you're starting by labeling all the states. And then you're going to connect the dots of the roads. For example, Boston Post Road. You're going to start with your pencil or brown crayon. Actually, you're doing this with a brown crayon. You're going to start with a brown crayon on Boston. And look how the next place you connect to is Providence, Rhode Island. So you're going to draw a line from Boston to Providence. From Providence, Rhode Island, then you're going to New York City. Oops. And eventually, you're going to just draw that line, keep connecting that line to Philadelphia. So on your map, you're going Boston, Providence, New York City, and Philadelphia. You're going to label that Boston Post Road. Essentially, you're connecting the dots, like those little things you used to do as a kid, where you connect the dots and eventually it makes a picture. Well, this doesn't really make a picture, but it does show you where early American roads go. You'll do the Coastal Post Road. It'll start at Philadelphia, draw a line to Baltimore, draw a line to Washington, D.C., draw a line to Richmond, Virginia, and to Raleigh, North Carolina. And you'll eventually connect the whole way down to St. Augustine down here in Florida. Essentially, that is today's Interstate 95. Maybe you've driven on that, going from the Hanover area down to Disney or somewhere in Florida. So you're going to connect all those roads. It's going to show us where these roads go. The Mohawk Turnpike, the Chicago Turnpike. Although with that one, be sure you don't go across Lake Michigan. You want to stay on land. We still don't have a bridge capability to build a bridge big enough to cross Lake Michigan. So you make sure you go around the land and stay out of Lake Michigan. Now, after you have finished those roads, I would like you to color northern states blue, southern states red, western states yellow. And here they are. Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, etc. are going to be northern states. Southern states are the ones on your map that I have listed here. They become red. Western states become yellow. It's important you get those colored correctly because later on we're going to have a big fight between these three. And I want you to know what region they're in. Please do that last. And do that with crayons as opposed to markers. Over on my table, next to the windows, I put the markers away. So you only have crayons. But you definitely want to do this last because crayons have kind of a waxy quality to them. If you do the coloring first and then try to write on top of it, it won't work. That's why I'm asking you to label the states first. Abbreviations are good. And then do all the roads and then put the color on top because it works much better that way. Okay, so there's directions about the maps, the road map and such. The third thing you're doing today is use the rates of toll sheet to complete this activity. So you see this one that says rates of toll? It tells you how much it would cost to move, let's say, 20 sheep, for example, along the national road. Maybe it tells you what a horse and a rider costs. This is the toll you pay as you use those roads, much like we pay a toll to use the Pennsylvania Turnpike today, or the New Jersey Turnpike, or the Delaware Bay Bridge, or whatever it is. So when you open this, you'll see this is a short little quiz, and you are going to, well, if you've done the other things, when you do the quiz, it'll ask you, like how much money does it take to move a certain thing along the national road? It's not that tough. I'm sure Crimmel and Stam will be very proud of your math skills that you can do this. Yes, you might have to use a little math. And then finally, the last thing I want you to do today. Is I want you to watch this Oregon Trail video about moving west. You know, the roads and highways are great, but there are people still moving the whole way across the country. So you do the Oregon Trail video, you answer the questions as you do that. All right, finally, if you finish early with any of those things, you can watch CNN 10. You can practice for your state's test, which is coming up on November 22nd. All right, that's your job for today. I expect on Friday, when I return, a couple things. One thing is that window table and all the crayons, all the stuff is going to be nice and neat. That will not be a pig pen of crayons. I will expect that no one is using their mask to cut lines in my seats like TikTok told you to do. Don't do that. I will also expect that you're going to have this done. You're going to have done the video of me yapping about new roads. You'll have the map done really well. You will do this well, connecting the dots of the highways and things. And to do the rates of toll, I also expect you, I'll give this matching thing a try. See if you can match the different vehicles from the early 1800s version to today's version. All right, hope you have a great day. I'll be back on Friday. See you then.